Hello, my friend. Welcome to TubeU channel. Following the official release of SDXL 1.0 motor by the Stability AI team, numerous tutorials have emerged on how to install the SDXL motor on your local computer. This new motor is anticipated to bring about a significant shift, but its true potential can only be fully realized with the inclusion of the ControlNet function. Thankfully, the ControlNet Canny component became accessible 2 days ago. Let's proceed to download and explore its capabilities. Visit the homepage provided in the description below and download the motor file. Place it within the stable diffusion folder, specifically the extensions SDWebUI ControlNet Motors subfolder. Both SD Automatic 1111 and ComfyUI can seamlessly integrate this motor without encountering any issues. Then, navigate the ComfyUI folder and open the command prompt, CMD. Within the command line interface, enter the command copied from the homepage. Do the same process for SD Automatic 1111. Once all processes are completed, restart the SD Automatic 1111 or ComfyUI batch file accordingly. In my case, only need to restart the total BAT file. You can check my previous video that how to combine all your projects in one file. You only need to select one when starting the project. However, I couldn't ascertain how to utilize this motor with SD Automatic 1111. Consequently, I attempted to implement it through ComfyUI. I designed a simple workflow that begins by generating the normal SDXL motor. Subsequently, I employed a refiner to create a refined image. This refined image was then utilized as the input image for the ControlNet Canny function. Finally, 4x ultra scale function was applied to yield the ultimate image. The control mode can be found in the list at the bottom. Let's try a few basic examples. The process proved highly effective, although there were instances where it froze without providing any error information. Identifying the root cause remains uncertain. To mitigate this, I have updated the NVIDIA driver and other associated components. Hopefully, this issue will be resolved without requiring my direct intervention. Here are a few tips that might assist you. Ensure that both the SDXL motor and the refine motor are placed in the correct folder, verifying that you can directly select the ControlNet motor. If not, confirm its placement in the proper folder, or relocate it to the ComfyUI ControlNet folder. Avoid utilizing an empty image in the ControlNet key sampler latent image, as this could lead to an empty audible image. You can directly implore the generated image as the input image, utilizing the refined image for the ControlNet input. Adjusting the denoising value can substantially alter the image, tailor it to your preferred outcome. Subsequently, I embarked on an alternative workflow utilizing direct image input. I proceeded to modify hair and eye color through a similar prompt. Begin by loading the image you intend to use as a ControlNet sample. Transform this image into another using the Canny function. This newly generated image will serve as the ControlNet input image. Ensure that the appropriate ControlNet model is selected. The amalgamation of this diverse information is employed as image-positive input data in the K-sampler. The K-sampler model also opts for the SDXL base model. You possess the flexibility to fine-tune the K-sampler parameters to your performance. Following this, the final image and a 4x upscaled version are generated. The image generation process takes approximately 400 seconds. Presently, the speed associated with ControlNet remains relatively low, even after experimenting with other parameters like introducing --MetVRAM in the command argument line or manipulating the inclusion of XFormers. The ComfyUI initialization process remains unchanged. It consistently utilizes this function. The resultant image confirms to my intended modifications, adjusting the hair and eye colors accordingly. However, further refinement may be required to optimize image quality, particularly concerning other parameters like sampler, CFG, etc. In any case, the ControlNet function works exceptionally well, devoid of any issues. As we eagerly await the release of other ControlNet functions, the full potential of SDXL ControlNet is poised to outshine even the renowned MidJournal, regardless of the scenario. If you're enjoying my content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching.